Where to?
Look who's back. Couldn't stay away, could you? Mm-hmm. Oh, I suppose I should just tear it up. But I can't. I can't rip up the product of that man's soul. Here, would you tear it up for me? Thanks. Are they? I mean, did you? It must have been difficult. But take some comfort in knowing if you hadn't, someone else would have had to. I do appreciate your help. A lot. Can't you tell? I simply adore you. You're so sweet to me. The way you protect me. What would I have done had you never come in here? Oh. Why can't they all be like you? The world could be so, so beautiful. Here, take this. A reminder of the beautiful girl whose heart you stole.
Do I know you? I tell you when hell freezes over, but there's always that chance that it might. So, let me just go with the definite no way in hell.
Just might. Why don't you ask everyone else in the world? They'd know. Present. And I bet. Sun's gone down. Never mind. Me neither. What's the catch? To say yes would be an understatement. I wouldn't care anyway. I could just do it. just walk out of here and do it. Maybe I move, maybe I don't. That's the difference. You didn't see me? Hunters, you crawled back inside my club. I tried to leave the moon. So I had to ask myself, if I go out there, then I prepare to die. How many can I take out before returning strike, huh? 2, 3. I could just walk out there, right now, blaze of glory, be it. And you know what? Knowing that, it doesn't bother me. And I guess the only reason I haven't walked out yet is because I'm trying to figure out why it doesn't bother me. Hey, did Isaac send you? What the hell, then, would be your motivation to help me? The only group I belong to is the Actors Union. I avoid all that clan crap. And what do you propose we do? Did you get that idea from a sitcom? Whatever. Look around the club. Maybe you'll get lucky.
Haven't I seen you in here before?
Cash?
What do I have to do?
Sure, I can do that. I thought you were going to make me eat a tarantula or stick a worm up my nose.
We really hope to get these homeless from the temp agency, because all the clothes going to do is have a laugh. If it works, I'm out of this city. Here, talk about it.
Hola.
You still don't have it, do you? I didn't doubt you'd find this, and I apologize if I was overly imperious before. A reflex action. I get a lot of young blood in here forgetting their place. I'll assist you as reasonably as I can with your task. But first, this tape. I'm in a hurry to find out what's behind all the hype, so get comfortable. I do have a feeling that whatever's here may be of use to both of us. It's more disturbing than I was led to believe. You can understand my concern now, can't you? I assume it does. It's awfully coincidental otherwise. And those creatures. I don't know how many professional FX houses could pull those off. There's a problem, though, in that the film's incomplete. The first half is damaged. We need a complete copy. Behind the spit-shine gloss of the Hollywood Dream Factory is another city churning out a vile byproduct for the furtive consumption of a debauched audience. I have no doubt the film's found its way to another smut peddler. I'd ask around.
What can I do to you, honey? Yeah? What do you want to know? Those guys? Yeah, I heard of them. Why do you want to know? Really? You a cop? All right, listen. I'll tell you a little bit, but if anyone comes asking, you never heard it from me. They produce only the most hardcore video. I'm not even talking black market here, more like black hole market. Not the kind of product you want to get mixed up in. The kind of stuff that gets you put in jail for just talking about it, all right? Snuff films is just the tip of the iceberg. I only seen one of their videos, and I swear I couldn't eat for a week. Real enough that every cop in 5 states has been trying to track these guys down. They are bad news, pal. You want some advice from me? Stop thinking whatever you're thinking and get your ass back to Kansas. A tape? You mean the tape? You've got a copy of it? Have you seen it? Look, man, get the hell out of here, all right? I don't want any part of that scene. I hear people seeing that tape ain't been coming home for dinner. I don't deal in that kind of stuff anyway, so just take it somewhere else. Forget it, man. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. Huh? What? Who are they? Seriously, get the hell out of here. Okay. Look, all I know is that a guy calls on the payphone down the street every once in a while. He'll say something like, the moon is a terrible mistress, or some creepy shit like that. And then all you have to say is, who walks the night with demons of dread? Supposedly you'll be told where to meet the guy to pick up product. I don't know for sure. I never tried it. It scared the shit out of me. Hey, wait. Look, you might as well know this. Word on the street is that they didn't even make the video. They're just distributing it. No one even knows where it comes from. I'm telling you, man. Whatever you're in, get out of it now.
The moon is a mysterious mistress. The Lucky Star Motel, Room 2, don't be long.
Hola.
Jesus, man, what the fuck is going on up there? Dead everyone, slaughtered up. Oh, God. Shh. Don't make any noise. They'll hear us. Yeah, no. Fuck it. Yeah, I'm with DMP, U50. Yeah, I know, but we didn't make that shit. One of the guys stole it, found it in the creepy house in the hills. We just copied it and put our names on it. Worse than anything we ever did. Worst thing I ever saw. Just get me out of here. Oh, no. Ah!
Any luck? Then this is no doubt the work of a fiend. Hand me the tape. There might be something on it that will give us some insight into what its motives are. House in the tape. I know it. It's in the hills. King's Way, if I'm not mistaken. My guess is that the fiend that made this tape is using these creatures to hound the Nosferatu, which would explain their sudden absence. They're trapped. Well, it's unfortunate that the Prince needs you to see the Nosferatu, because it looks like this fiend knows how to get at them, and I doubt he's going to draw a map for you. Looks like King's Way is your only way in, unfortunately. If I may give you one final word of warning, do not trust LaCroix. Do not play the damned politics of the Camarilla. This city hasn't needed them in a long time, and won't ever. That's for you to decide. I only know who you can't trust.
Hola.
I wonder how they microwave burritos in the Middle Ages.
Where to?
Money, right?
Been a while.
Your money's been piling up. Here, that should provide for an interesting evening.
Mr. Melton. You know who this is, and I do hope you realize that we're still on for tonight. Meet me at the agreed-upon location across from the bar by the underpass. Bring your associate, Mr. Durbin, as it is a two-man job that I am proposing. With any luck, the two of you are already on your way, and I shall see you soon. Goodbye.
You're back. I went out this evening and I met someone and he wouldn't leave me alone, so he came back here with me and, well, I thought you might want to drink his blood.
Looks like somebody's been waiting in the queue quite a while to speak to you. So, caller,
I'm just glad you're pleased. He's in the bathroom. Don't worry, I locked him in.
Or tripping.
You know, when you fall asleep, they can crawl into your mouth or your ears or your nose. You can't prevent it if you're asleep. I mean, what can you do?
Are there any scientists out there listening to this?
I read something. I don't know where. But do you know the average person eats several pounds of insects a year? The majority of that weight is composed of roaches, ants, and spiders. Just knowing that as soon as you close your eyes, a big fat centipede is gonna drop into your mouth and crawl down your throat. I can't do it. I never sleep at night.
You know, they voluntarily eat insects in some countries.
Yeah, well, those countries probably need Jesus.
So, you never sleep at night. I assume you do sleep, right?
I sleep at work.
And what exactly do you do?
I'm a middle school teacher.
That would explain why my nephew invested that 20 I sent him for his birthday on magic. It's always good to know that the future of our country is in good hands, isn't it? Oh boy. Let's see who else we got. Caller, what do you do for a living?
I'm Roger.
Okay, and what do you do, Roger?
I'm a writer, Deb.
So, have you written any movies I might have seen?
Well, I actually haven't finished any screenplays yet.
I see. So, have you done any other kinds of writing?
Well, just some outlines right now, but I've got some really good ideas for some stories that are crawling around in the old noggin.
So, if you haven't really written anything, how can you call yourself a writer? Because I once fixed my toilet doesn't make me a plumber, right?
What do you mean?
Is there anyone in this city that doesn't call themselves a writer, or actor, or director?
Hey, what the hell is this shit? Let me out, goddammit! I'll kill that crazy bitch!
Deeming yourself something you're not, or not even trained to do?
Psycho bitch brought me here, hit me in the head, and locked me up. What the fuck? I mean, who the fuck does that?
Let's see if anyone else agrees. Line two, are you ready for a menage a trois?
Sure thing, Deb.
And would you please state what you do for a living?
I'm a personal...
Oh, so she's gonna play it like that, huh? All right, just let me out. I want to get as far away from that crazy bitch as possible.
Well, for our writer on the phone, here's your big chance to pitch your screenplay. Is that okay, line two?
Sell me, dude.
Well, okay. My story's about this guy.
You don't say.
Okay, so this guy, he's like an FBI agent. You know, he doesn't really work for the main FBI. And he's got this partner who's new and really cute, but she's also a really good agent. And they're like a side partner.
Thank you.
It's you. Earlier tonight, you weren't following me, were you? I had this feeling like I was being watched. Maybe it's nothing, but I'm still a little shook up. But I... You don't mean it! I'll leave, okay? But if you ever change your mind... All right.
More flatbread and olive oil. And take back the Chardonnay and open up a Chianti. Let it breathe for 20 minutes and then bring it out with a ziti. Okay? Wanted to know what? Interrupt me while I'm working? Do you understand that this is an important opening and I, emphasize I, am going to make or possibly break this restaurant? Me, Tommy Flayton, the food authority of Los Angeles, food critic for the biggest paper on the West Coast, radio personality for the KTLK, Chower Hour. Maybe if I reviewed more pancake huts, you'd know me. I'm not sure exactly what you mean. How so? You know, now that you mention it, the New Yorkie was a bit cold. And the ravioli might have been store-bought. Also, the decorum's a bit lacking, isn't it? This place is just an overpriced cafeteria! No stars!
Yes. I'm going to write a review that will destroy this restaurant.
Hey,
You head to King's Way yet? Certainly. There is something, but it involves a gargoyle. I can see that's got your attention. It's taken up residence in my beloved Asian theater. It is closed now, but that's beside the point. I sent some people to evict it, and it sent them back with a few less limbs. I can't have that monster attacking kindred in my city. It's a walking block of stone with a taste for blood. I'd suggest whatever method doesn't result in you being eviscerated. In truth, I'd rather have it as an ally, but I doubt it's going to be chatty. Here's the key for the theater. I'll leave it up to you. Certainly. The Nosferatu? I pity them, but I loathe their presence. I deal with them when it's necessary. I know they're beneath my city somewhere, but only they know where. They respect my streets and I keep my politics out of their sewers, but I don't trust them by any stretch of the word. Certainly. In your lifetime, unwittingly or not, you have seen an Isaac Abrams production. As the financier of 30% of American film's top 100 movies, you must have. Being the Baron of Hollywood, I can do any project I want. Stewart, Lean, Hitchcock, Wilder, Holden, Dean, Scorsese, De Niro, and last but not least, Ash, my child. I remember some studio suit lost in time telling me the only thing they could use Bogart for was to move furniture. Ash, where do I begin? 7 years ago, I saw a casting session for what would become Negative Zero. The moment I set eyes on him, the passion of his performance, I knew he had it. I hadn't seen anything like him since Clift or Dean. He had the looks, the charisma, allure, that undefinable quality that makes a film legend. My first movie with him made him a sensation, and it also changed him. I acted on impulse. I'd seen so many others die before their time, but with Ash, I had a chance to prevent that fate. It devastated Ash. He still wanted to act, but I denied him his place in the limelight. He had to lie to his friends about his new lifestyle. He had to feed. I gave him a club, a scrap of his former glory. I did everything I could to facilitate the change. He feels obligated to me. I don't think he hates me. Resents me, maybe. I am his sire, and he is my child, and there is a responsibility and respect inherent in that bond, even if we are no longer the friends we were. He spends nearly all of his nights in his club, the Asp Hole. I admit it, too old-fashioned to appreciate it. To me, it's the compressed essence of everything that's wrong with the film industry today.
from your bones. Talk? No. Always kindred are talking, scheming, hurting others with their lies. Monsters you all, abominations, a curse upon the earth. Arthur, what offer? Yet another lie? He hopes to control me, to enslave me, just as my master before him. First he sends his underlings to destroy me, and now he wants to make peace. No! Curse him! Curse you all! What is this? Another devilish trick? Am I to trade one chain for another? Bow to Abrams now, instead of my old master? Never! Camarilla! What means this, Camarilla? Fights against his own kind. The Tremere. Hate them above all your kind, I do. Secrecy and sorcery, betrayal and blood magic. Damned to hell are all of you, but the Tremere most of all. Yes, I will fight alongside this Abrams and help him in his battle against this Camarilla. Lifeless demon he may be, but I swear to fight at his side. Yes, now leave me. This theater is my domain, and I seek the peace of solitude.
You head to King's Way yet? A gargoyle serving in the defense of Hollywood. Exceptional.
I'm sure it'll come as quite a surprise to the first shock troop that crosses the city line. You've got a lot of promise. It's a shame you're still working full-time for the wrong side. I'd like to hope so. Well, if you'll excuse me.
To. young K-Knight. I see your face is not so lifeless. Your nerves not so deadened that you cannot express shock. Tell me, child, is my appearance that frightening? Or is it my knowledge of you that is so unnerving? Oh, child of Cain, the sights in this haven pale in comparison to my ancestral estate. Comfort is a custom, and all of this artifice brings me closer to my home. Do not fear for my furniture, young one. Oh yes, the tape. Merely a test. Certainly not intended to fall into mortal hands. Fortunately, we are in the capital of mortal trickery and illusion. So did the tape drive you to find me? From whence flows your longing, child? To gouge out the eyes of the Camarilla. The sewers are clogged with my creations. I will kill or drive the Nosferatu from their pestilent nests. Without the sewer rats to guide them, the Camarilla will be blind to the Sabbat's designs. It is not for me. It's for the will of the Sabbat. The Camarilla is stunted, dead and festering in the womb. Good only as pawns of the fathers. Even now, they answer the call of the ancient and seek to free him from his torpor. He slumbers within the Ankaran sarcophagus, one of the fathers whose return shall hearken the reckoning. Kuhena is at hand, and the Camarilla are unwittingly speeding us all toward our doom. Blessed creatures, I have broken through their mortal crust and drawn from them their greatest strength, mutability. I coax bone, weave flesh, and lay sinew tight until it strains to lash out. Illegals, mongrels, half-bloods, and caitiff, the bane of society, kindred and kin. They are as of little consequence to authority as they are to me. It is a culling of sorts. Perhaps. But they are exquisitely functional. Still, there's an uncanny elegance to even this, my most mercenary of designs. Revulsion is instinctual, and instinct is a powerful level to work toward. To evoke it, a glorious accomplishment. Revulsion is a striking color on my palette. I see wonderment in your dead eyes. You long to wield such power as deftly as I. You are instantly known to me. I smell your vitae and can imagine the taste of your viscera on my talons. Ah, yes. It's in the blood. Strong and balmy. It is not yours to hide, child. Do not fear your nature, child. Your body is not a dead husk, but a chrysalis of beastly splendor. Embrace it. I can take your body, this passing mortal machine, and reshape it into an engine of canine fury. Now, Camarilla Whelp, let me see you fight your nature in the face of those who have embraced their beast. Deny yourself Cain's gifts, and be torn asunder by my minions.
Yeah.